Hello, this is Dr. York-Hammons. I'd like to show you how you can use StatCrunch to construct a frequency distribution table including midpoints, relative frequencies, and cumulative frequencies. I'm going to use example 1 on page 41 of your Pearson eText. The example gives us 30 prices of GPS navigators, and we're going to construct a frequency distribution table that has 7 classes. I don't want to have to retype this data, but almost all of the ones in your homework give you the option of opening them in StatCrunch. In this case, we have an icon that says SC, and when I click on it, it will open those 30 data points in a column in StatCrunch. You can see GPS prices. If I click on that, you can see that the rest of it in dollars is there as well. If I scroll down, you can see that there are indeed 30 GPS prices in our column. In order for us to find class width and the lower limit of the first class, we need to know information such as the minimum, the maximum, and the range. I don't actually have to sort this data if I use statistics to find the minimum, the maximum, and the range. To do that, click on Stat, scroll down to Summary Stats, and then over to Columns because our data of GPS prices is in a column. If you click on that, you see GPS prices in blue, in the blue box. We want it to be selected in the white box, so we just click on it. And it says we have selected that particular column. Now there are a wide range of statistics that you can select, but the only ones we are interested in are minimum, maximum, and range. I'm going to click on minimum, and you see it clears the column with minimum, but I also want max and range. So I'm going to hold my control key down while I click on max and range. And you see that it will put them in that order. When I get my table for my spreadsheet, you'll see them in that order. I'm going to scroll down and ask it to store the information in the data table. So if I click compute, this shows me that I've added columns of data to the data table. If I click on that, it will close it, but it doesn't delete it. It just hides it back here in the StatCrunch background. If you click on StatCrunch and results hidden, I can see that you used summary stats to get minimum, maximum, and range. To find the class width, we take the range and divide it by the number of classes, which in this case is 7. I can use a command from the data box to build an expression or compute an expression, but I have to build it. To find the class width, I will take the range. You need to double click it and it will show up here. I'm going to take the range and divide it by the number of classes, which in this problem is 7. I'm going to click OK and I'm going to tell it to put it in a column labeled class width. Now it's not going to round it to the nearest whole, it's not going to round it up to a most convenient number. It's going to give us a decimal value. And again, I'm just going to close that out and hide that I just did that. But by class width, we don't use 39.28574. We're actually going to use 40, the next higher whole number. So what I'd like to do is in var 7, I'm going to label that lower limit for each class, and my lower limit always starts with the minimum. So I begin my lower limit with 65. To get to my next, that's for class 1, to get to my next class lower limit, I have to add the class width, and we're going to use 40. 65 plus 40 would be 105. So I have my first lower limit, my second class lower limit, my third class, I'm going to add 40 again, 145, and I'm going to continue doing that until I have the lower limit for all 7 classes. So I believe that will be 185 to 25 to 65 and 305. So we have class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5, class 6, class 7. We have all 7 classes. So in var 8, I'm going to retitle that upper limit. Now the upper limit for a class, like for the first class, is 1 less than the lower limit for the second class. So if this is 105, then my upper limit for class 1 is going to be 104, the number before. Now, if you like, you can simply look at the next row down and then go one before that. So instead of one where we had 145, now we'll have 144. So it goes 144, 145. The next lower limit is 185. So our upper limit will be 184. The next one will be 224. Then we take that 265 and go back one. So it's 264. We take the 305 and go back to 304. And then to get each one of these is 40 apart as well. So to get to the upper limit for the seventh, I just add 40 to 304 and I get 344. So we have our lower limits and our upper limits. Now the next thing we need to find is a frequency for these classes. Now, the frequency is easier to find if we create a histogram of the original data. So if you will go to graph, scroll down to histogram, and click, we're going to use the original GPS price in dollars. We are going to do a frequency histogram. Now our bins, these are talking about the classes. They call it bins, but it's really the classes. Remember, the first class, and I can't get it to show. Let's see if I can widen this up. The first class started at 65. So my bins are going to start at 65, and the width that I used was 40, so I put 40. And this is really important. Put the value above each bar because that's going to be the frequency that you type in to the column that I just labeled. So I'm going to click compute and we get this nice little graph here. And so from 65, not up to 105, it's actually, if you scroll over, you can see that the GPS's include 65, but that parenthesis at 105 says everything up to but not including. So my first frequency is 6, my next frequency is 9, the next frequency is 6, for my fourth class it's 4, for my fifth class it's 2, and for my sixth class it's 1. Sorry, I clicked on that and didn't intend to turn it pink. And I'll go over here to the clear on the far left so that pink will go away. And then for my seventh class and final, the frequency is 2. Now you don't want to delete this. I mean, you have an option where you could, but do not delete that. What you want to do is save it, because if I asked you to create a frequency histogram, if that was the question, that this is what you needed, you will have it in this StatCrunch file. When I close this, you'll see that 2 go up to a 3. And when I click on StatCrunch, you'll see that histogram. It's hidden, but I can pull it back up and see that you created that histogram. So this will be excellent to turn in with a test or to do your homework if I ask you to show work. So I'm going to close it and it's hidden again. So we have our lower limit, our upper limit, and we have the frequency. Another thing that we might want to check is to make sure that our frequency adds up to the total number of GPS prices, which is 30. So you can go to data and compute an expression. And the expression we're going to build is the sum You can either scroll down till you find some, or you actually could just type it in. Double click, and we want the sum of the frequencies. I'm going to click OK. I'm not going to put it in a column. I just want to see that it adds up to, well, I did put it in a column. I apologize for that. It added a column. The sum of the frequencies is 30. I'm actually going to edit that and see if I can it looks like I'm not going to be able to get it out of there, but it did add it to the table. I know the frequency is 30. I'm going to close that, and I'm actually going to hit Shift and those two, and Control X, and it will delete that column. I don't want that column there right now. I think I would like to do one of the other things it asks us for in the table. If we go back to your book, we've done the lower limit, the upper limit. We've got the frequency and showed that it was equal to 30. The next thing that it wants us to look at is a midpoint. So we can take the lower class limit plus the upper class limit and divide by 2. So I'm going to do a midpoint. So my next column is going to be midpoint. And I go to data. And I'm going to make an I'm going to compute an expression again. And I have to build it. I'm going to do a parenthesis. I'm going to take the lower limit plus the upper limit. And then I'm going to divide that. Oops. I need to backspace that and get outside the parentheses before I divide so that it adds them and then divides by 2. And I'll put it in column label midpoint. So right after frequency in var 10, we should get a new column labeled midpoint, and it will compute them for each of the classes. I'm going to hide that in my StatCrunch. So the midpoints, notice that they are 40 apart. Our class width, the midpoints are 40 apart as well. Now, to find relative frequency, we take the frequency and divide it by the sum of frequencies, which is 30. If you've forgotten how many pieces are in your, how many data points are in your set, you can actually just go compute expression, build a new one, and we're going to take the frequency and we will divide it by, and I'm going to go down to sum because the number of elements in your data set is the sum of your frequency. So we're going to take the frequency divided by the sum of that column, and I'm going to call it the relative frequency. And I'm going to hide that, and so you can see the relative frequencies here. We could round these off if you want to. I'm going to leave them the way they are for right now. We need to do a cumulative frequency. So I'm going to go to data. I'm going to go compute expression. I'm going to build. And I'm going to do a cumulative sum of the frequencies. And I'm going to put that in a column called cumulative frequency and compute. And you'll see that we start off with 6. 6 plus 9 is 15. Add 6 more is 21, and so on down to where we get 30, which is the total in our set. Now, you've completed the entire frequency distribution table with all of the information that they could ask. These would probably need to be rounded in your homework. To save this, you go to StatCrunch, Session, Download. Now, you can change